Hi friends, welcome to another garden-inspired activity for National Gardening Month. Today we'll be making nature-inspired pinch clay pots. Take a nature walk with your child and encourage him or her to pocket a few treasures. Today, I picked up tree blossoms, small-sized pine cones, a nutshell, textured twig, and a small clipping from an evergreen tree. Try to look for natural elements that have a lot of texture. These blossoms have many layers of petals. These pine cones also have a lot of texture, and I picked up the smaller ones since our clay pots are small. This nutshell has great lines in particular, and the hard exterior will make it easy to make an indent in the clay. Same goes for this twig. You can use them both to stamp patterns in the clay using the end. The needles on this clipping are firm and will probably make a great print in the clay as well. Today, I'm using Crayola's Model Magic Clay. You can easily make your own clay with cornstarch and baking soda as well if you need to make a big batch, which is probably more economical if you have your own classroom. I'll leave a link below for a recipe just in case. To begin, you'll want to divide your clay up and begin rolling it in a ball. This activity is great for helping your little ones develop fine motor skills, meaning the tiny muscles in their fingers. Eye-hand coordination benefits from this activity as well. Once you have your ball, push your thumb into the clay to make the center of the pot. Easy, right? Then work your fingers around the sides to shape it the way you'd like. Turn the pot over and simply apply a soft pressure to the clay. I'm using a rocking motion here with a shell to make a print all around the sides of the pot. When I used the blossoms, I realized the petals were too soft to see any noticeable marks in the clay. I use the same motion I used with the nutshell and the pine cones. You can encourage your child to fold over the edges of the clay to create designs as well. It may be easier to use a small cup like this as a guide if they're still working on applying soft pressure. You can recycle an old mouthwash cup, as I'm using here. Be careful not to press the clay around too hard or it may be difficult to remove. The evergreen clipping turned out really well. And lastly, the twig. I found that there were some interesting lines and shapes on this side of the twig, which I decided to use to make some prints in the clay. As you're doing the sensory activity, talk to your child about how the clay feels. Introduce them to words like squish, poke, press, squeeze, roll, pound, pull, and tear. Ta-da! All you have to do now is leave it to dry. You can finish it off with Mod Podge and give it a natural looking glaze, and even use paint to decorate it. It's really all about exploration and experimentation of this great medium